and gentlemen.
In the late 1990s, Christian comedian Gordon Douglas was finally getting his big break. But at the same time, he began experiencing problems with his voice.
All of a sudden, I went to Texas to do this TV show. I lost my voice just dramatically overnight and just could barely speak.
She says that living with a comedian is like being on a vacation. Well, her actual words were, I were her last resort.
I tell people it's almost like swallowing a box of toothpicks. There was like things just jabbing or hurting and just infected and swollen. And I went to doctors and ear, nose, and throat specialists, and they put cameras down my throat. And they gave me all that, you know, you can't speak, you know, you need 6 months off, you need a year off, your vocal cords are stretched. And they basically told me I'd have to give up comedy. It was devastating.
Gordon worked through the pain and branded himself the comedian with the froggy voice. Then in 2002, while playing basketball, he injured the cartilage surrounding his larynx, essentially breaking his Adam's apple.
The guy got a rebound and he turned and his elbow went right into my voice box. I went to my doctor who sent me to a specialist, and he said, you can't break your Adam's apple. And I said, well, feel mine. And he put his hand on it, and it just crackled like potato chips. Three or four different specialists all said, you know, you'll never speak like that again. Don't expect anything back.
For two more years, Gordon kept doing his shows with a strained voice. Then one Monday night in 2004, while home with his family,
we were all gathered in the living room watching Monday Night Football. So during the one break in the football game, my wife starts flipping channels, and pop, the 700 Club comes on. There's two people praying, and I said, well, let's listen to this. And then all of a sudden,
someone else, you have a problem with like the cords in your neck. I don't know if you've had an injury or what, but God's healing that condition for you.
And boy, when that thing came on and talked about vocal cords, and I had been struggling for 6 years and praying and fasting and begging God, please give me my voice back. Man, we got on our knees and we prayed. This is such an amazing thing for me. This is outside my theological framework. I mean, God doesn't speak to me this way. So I called a friend of ours, a Pentecostal charismatic preacher up the road. I said, what do I do? He said, receive it. You think that's an accident that you would turn the TV to that station at that time? And all of a sudden a guy saying somebody broke their vocal cords. I mean, how many people have ever done that? He said, it might not be this minute. It might not be tomorrow, but you thank God till your voice is back. 3 days later, I was scheduled to speak. And in the morning, a lady had called to go over the details of the show that night. And when I answered the phone, she said, I'm looking for the comedian, Gordon Douglas. And I said, well, you got him. And she said, no, the funny guy, the guy with the froggy voice. And I said, well, you got him. You got him. You got him. You got him. My voice was 100% back. I mean, not a trace of an injury, 100% back. And I am shouting and praising and I'm yelling, I can talk, I can talk, I can talk.
It's been over 7 years since Gordon was healed, and his voice has remained 100% restored.
God is real, and he is there, and he's so much bigger than what we expect. And he knows right where we are. And he not only does it just for me, his love for me is the same as everybody's.